Many relationships fail not because the partners don't put in the effort, but because they are expressing their love in the wrong ways. She says, "Can you empty trash outside?" He hears, "Nag, nag, nag." He says, "We haven't had sex in a month." She thinks, "When was the last time you bought me something that wasn't a domestic device?" When you learn to understand and speak your partner's love language, you will be able to effectively express your love and truly feel loved in return. In this video, we'll highlight some great ideas from the book The 5 Love Languages, How to Express Heartfelt Commitment to Your Mate by Gary Chapman. The insight in this book can be very helpful for many in relationships. This book outlines 5 ways to express and experience love that Gary Chapman calls love languages. According to this theory, each person has one primary and one secondary love language. What are the 5 love languages? The first love language is words of affirmation. According to Chapman, this language uses words to affirm other people. If this is your love language, unsolicited compliments mean the world to you. For those who prefer the words of affirmation language, hearing "I love you" and other compliments are what they value the most. Words hold real value within this language. Furthermore, negative or insulting comments cut deep and won't be easily forgiven. The second love language is quality time. This language is all about giving the other person your undivided attention. Unlike the words of affirmation language, talk is cheap and being a loved one's main focus leaves quality time as feeling satisfied. Distractions, postponed dates, or the failure to listen can be especially hurtful to these individuals. Being there for them is crucial. With the TV off, phone off and all chores and tasks on standby makes your significant other feel truly special and loved. The third love language is receiving gifts. Chapman says for some people, what makes them feel most loved is to receive a tangible gift. This should not be mistaken for materialism, but a meaningful and thoughtful present makes them feel appreciated. The fourth love language is acts of service. Can doing laundry or dishes be an expression of love? Absolutely. Anything you do to ease the burden of responsibilities weighing on an acts of service person will speak volumes. For these people, actions speak louder than words. Lending a helping hand shows you really care. People who thrive on this language do not deal well with broken promises or perceived laziness and have very little tolerance for people who make more work for them. Basically, if you're not willing to show your appreciation by doing them a favor, you're saying you don't value them. Lastly, the fifth love language is physical touch. To this person, nothing speaks more deeply than appropriate touch. That doesn't mean only in the bedroom, but everyday physical connections such as hugs, pats on the back, holding hands and thoughtful touches on the arm, shoulder, or face among others. A person whose primary language is physical touch is, not surprisingly, very touchy. Physical presence and accessibility are crucial, while neglect or abuse is a total deal breaker. Gary Chapman suggests that to discover another person's love language, one must observe the way they express love to others, and analyze what they complain about most often and what they request from their significant other most often. He theorizes that people tend to naturally give love in the way that they prefer to receive love, and better communication between mates can be accomplished when one can demonstrate care to the other person in the love language the recipient understands. An example would be if a husband's love language is acts of service. He may be confused when he does cook dinner for his wife and she doesn't perceive that as an act of love, viewing it as simply performing household duties, because the love language she comprehends is quality time. She may try to use what she values, quality time, to express her love to him, which he would not value as much as she does. If she understands his love language and mows the lawn for him, he perceives it in his love language as an act of expressing her love for him. Likewise, if he spends time with her giving her undivided attention, she values that as an act of love. Overall, it all comes down to knowing what's important to your mate so you can understand and express your love to them a little better. Everyone is different. I hope this video has been of great help in identifying your primary love language and your partner's. The decision to learn to express your partner's love language is yours to make. Thank you for watching. Kindly subscribe to this channel for more.